Welcome to my channel Competitive Exam Warriors. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and also don't forget to hit the bell button to stay updated to my latest notifications.
Friends, welcome all of you to my channel Competitive Exam Warriors. And today we'll be continuing with the existing topic, that is square root of a perfect square number. And as usual, it will be presented by me, that's your educator, Souvik Mitra. Before beginning, let's have a look at my achievement section. If you are a new viewer, you can have a look at all these things. And if you are a new viewer, definitely don't forget to hit the subscribe button and also don't forget to hit the bell icon to stay updated to my latest videos. Now, since it's related to maths, quant, it's important for banking aspirants. Similarly, it's important SSC, insurance, railways, and also important for UPSC and state PCS papers like UPSC, SAT, and everywhere where quant is being asked. Now, if you use my code, that is PLUSR4SVE, then you will be getting flat 10% off on any Earn Academy Plus option courses. And if you want agent discount, that too you can achieve using Earn Academy learning credits. So here I have already discussed that day the chart. In fact, I have discussed with you the square root of 576 and another example I have taken, that is of 729. Today we will be discussing with the third example, that is a bigger one, bigger figure this time, 4 digit long, that is 1764. So let's look at over here the explanation. So first of all, let's concentrate on the 10th and the digit over here, 10th and the unit digit over here, that is 64. Okay, 1764, we'll be concentrating on the last two digits and we'll be deciding what will be the unit digit in the square root. That is, it can be either 2 or it can be 8. Because according to the chart, whenever we do a square root of any perfect square number whose ending is in 4, that is unit digit itself 4, in the square root itself, the unit digit will be either 2 or it will be either 8. So we need to find out whether it will be 2 or 8. So dash 2 or 8, it will be the answer, that is the required square root. Now 17. Nearest square to 17 is 16. Okay. And square root of 16 is 4. So 4 will come over here. So the answer will be either 4, that is 42 or 48. The answer will be either 42 or 48. So you need to see whether it will be 42 or 48. Now 4, the next digit of 4 is 4 plus 1 5. So 4 into 5, it makes it 20. Okay, so 20 is greater than 17, or you can say that 17 is less than 20. So according to convention, we need to take the lower number, that is 2 over here. So you get, that is the square root of 1764 is 42. Okay, since we are getting 20, it's greater than 17, we need to take the lower number. If, for example, say, if the figure would have come out 16, less than 17, then we are taking this higher number. But here the opposite has occurred, so we have taken the lower number. Another example, and that will be the, this will be the last example of this topic. You need to find out the square root of 3481. 3481. Similarly, look at the last two digits. So the unit digit will be either 1 or it will be 9. Okay, according to the chart which I mentioned in the first slide. Now let's look at 34. Nearest square of 34 is 25, whose square root of 5. So the answer will be either 51 or 59. We need to find out whether it will be 51 or 59. Now 5. If we multiply 5 with the next number 6, it comes out to be 30, and 30 is less than 34, so we need to take the higher number according to convention. So this time the answer will be 59 and not 51. So you can get now that the answer will be 59, that is square root of 3481. Now you can practice at home taking more and more numbers. You can find them in any book or any website, mathematics and mean obviously, or any popular YouTube channel. You will be getting many examples to practice with. In fact, you can get them from book itself, or you can create numbers itself. using a calculator obviously. Please practice the square roots, because in exam time what may happen that you may forget the tricks or something if you don't practice enough. So please practice as much as possible. I hope that you have liked this lesson. If you have do like this lesson, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Share this with your friends as much as possible. And if you've got any query, don't forget, don't hesitate to write it in the comment section. I'll be happy to help you at the earliest. Okay. Don't forget to share this with your friends as much as possible. And also don't forget to subscribe. Hit the bell icon to stay updated. Let's meet in the next lesson. Till that time, stay tuned. God bless you all.